Gabon, Gabon eta ongi etorri aurtengo Donostia sariaren emanaldi honetara. Gaur gauean Donostia saria emakume aktore handi bati emango diogu. El Festival de San Sebastián se honra en hacer entrega del premio Donostia a una de las actrices norteamericanas más importantes, respetadas y reconocidas internacionalmente en las últimas décadas. Sigourney Weaver ha creado multitud de personajes memorables, tanto cómicos como dramáticos. Quizá podamos destacar entre todos ellos el Teniente Ripley de Alien o Diane Fossey en Gorilas en la niebla. Urteotan, publikoa bereganatzeaz gain, gehien baloratutako emakume aktoreetako bat bilakatu da, bai antzerkian eta baita pantalla handietan ere. Su trabajo con directores como Ridley Scott, James Cameron, David Fishner, Jean-Pierre Jeunet, Roman Polanski, Ang Lee o Night Shyamalan le han valido multitud de nominaciones para diversos premios. A lo largo de su trayectoria ha estado nominada 3 veces para los Oscars, 7 veces para los Globos de Oro, ganando 2 de estos galardones en 1989 por Gorilas en la niebla y Armas de mujer. Además de brillar en el cine, Sigourney Weaver también ha tenido tiempo para triunfar en los escenarios y en la televisión. Ha participado en numerosas producciones off-Broadway en Nueva York, lo que le ha permitido trabajar con dramaturgos de la talla de John Ware, Alberti Naruto, Richard Nelson y Len Yerkin, y ganar también un premio Tony por su papel protagonista en la obra Harley Barley de Mike Nichols. Telebistan, Emmy, zein urrezko globosarietarako izendapenak lortu ditu, eta baita aktorean sindikatuaren sarietarako ere, Prayers for Bobby filmean egindako lanagatik. Hoy, después de esta ceremonia, tendremos ocasión de disfrutar de su trabajo en la última película de Juan Antonio Bayona, A Monster Calls. Para entregar el premio, recibamos a Juan Antonio Bayona.
Yo también tengo miedo, ¿eh? Pero podré con ello. Para mí, es impresionante la lista de directores, los ha dicho Durne, pero quiero repetirlos, la lista de directores con los que ha trabajado Sigourney Weaver, Ridley Scott, James Cameron, Jean-Pierre Jeunet, David Fincher, Roman Polanski, Ang Lee, tengo que mirar la chuleta porque son muchos, Woody Allen, Peter Weir, Mike Nichols. Recuerdo que Mike Nichols falleció durante el rodaje de Un monstruo viene a verme, y recuerdo un día en una pausa de rodaje que me acerqué a hablar con ella. Ella tenía la mirada afligida, estaba como muy conmovida y hablamos, me habló del profundo amor que sentía ella por Mike Nichols, que era asimismo un director que amaba a sus actores. Yo creo que esa es la mayor sorpresa cuando uno conoce a Sigourney Weaver, ¿no? Descubrir esa sensibilidad, uno tiende a asociarla a la imagen, a la coraza de la Teniente Ripley, es normal porque la Teniente Ripley está considerada casi como el personaje femenino más importante de la historia. Y sin embargo, llama la atención cuando uno la conoce que es totalmente lo contrario, ¿no? Creo que realmente lo que hace de ella la mejor guerrera de la historia del cine no son ni su imponente presencia ni sus habilidades físicas, yo creo que es la sensibilidad y la vulnerabilidad con la que dota a todas sus creaciones. Cuando empezamos el rodaje de Un monstruo viene a verme, una de las cosas primeras que me dijo fue, vamos a ir a San Sebastián. Así que para mí es un honor tremendo entregar en nombre del Festival de San Sebastián el premio Donostia a Sigourney Weaver. Aquí tenemos un vídeo donde vamos a ver un clip con algunas de sus mejores creaciones.
Jaun andreok, con todos ustedes, Sigourney Weaver. Thank you so much.
Oh, please.
I'm already overwhelmed. Thank you. Tonight I am Spanish.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Muchas gracias, queridos amigos. Thank you so much. Eskari Kaskos. It is a great honor for me to be here tonight and receive this award from all of you in this country that I love and whose artists I admire so much. So I want to thank Jose Luis and everyone at the San Sebastian Film Festival, and to receive it from our amazing director, Bayona, is a great thrill, and I'd forgotten I said that about San Sebastian, but I was prescient. It also means so much to me because, as some of you know, San Sebastian was the very first festival I ever went to before many of you were born in 1979 with a little movie called Alien, which I realized, thinking about it, I actually hadn't seen before that night. And, you know, we, in those days, you went to the Victoria Eugenia Theater, and it was a beautiful, stately, grand old lady. And I remember I was there with my parents and our producer, David Giler, who spoke perfect Castilian Spanish. And we walked on a red carpet without any interviews, because that was considered very déclassé then. It was very dignified. And we walked up a staircase where Basque soldiers held out their swords, and you walked underneath this wonderful archway of swords. And then they took us to a box, and we watched the movie, and I'd never seen it before. And I knew the story, luckily. But it was such a remarkable night, so exotic for this girl from Manhattan. I'd never experienced Spain in this way. I'll never forget it. And I remember I received flowers, but David received a leek, a big leek, the vegetable. And I wasn't sure what it meant, but I think it was meant to bring us luck, and it certainly did. You know, when you receive a great honor like this, you think of, well, you think of all the wonderful people you've worked with in the past. I've been so fortunate to work all over the world, and I've been thinking about all the wonderful directors, including Hota, and the very generous actors, jolly people, and certainly the very hardworking and resourceful crews. So I'm thinking of all of them, and I share this award with all of them. Spain is one of my favorite places to work. It's true of many actors and people in this business. You know, in Spain, making movies is considered still a noble and artistic endeavor. Commerce is secondary. I mean, it's important, but it's not everything. And so it's always a great joy to work here. This is a place where the crew has usually read the script, and when you're on the floor shooting the scenes, you can actually feel them sending energy to you, rooting for the scene to go well.
and it's so exciting. I also want to tell you that from the very start, I knew that A Monster Calls would be a very special movie. First of all, it was written by a wonderful script by Patrick Ness, and he had made the inspired decision to have it be directed by Hota, who even at his young age is a master and really a visionary filmmaker. But what I really remember was being up in Manchester, England, which is in the north, and it was in September, and it was already very cold and wet and rainy, and we had about 30 Spanish crew up there who'd been there for weeks and were going to be there for a few more weeks. And I just remember them shivering in the cold and the rain. There was no sun, there were no tapas, no good wine, no music, no wonderful boulevards to stroll along, and only these rowdy Friday nights and lots of pub food and a lot of lager. And so I knew then how much they loved Hota to follow him up to this place. And I knew how much they believed in this film. And I feel like all that love and belief is in the movie you'll see tonight. And I'm so proud to be sharing it with you later because at San Sebastian is such a crossroads for so many different cultures and ideas. And it's fitting for this movie that I hope will go around the world and be loved by so many people. That we should start here tonight at San Sebastian. So thank you so much. Scotty Casco.
Jaun Andreok, zinemaldiak aurrera darrai orain, A Monster Calls filma ikusiko dugu. Gabon, muy buenas noches.